Hello everyone. So now we have seen the formulas and expressions for some of the two random variables, whether it is discrete or continuous or independent. Then in this case of the independent sum of independent random variables, we have one question on this. So this says, sum of two independent uniform random variables distributed on the region, let's say 0, 1, with x and y calculate the probability density of x plus y. Right, so we have two uniform random variables which are independent, and we have to check for the sum where the uniform random variables are defined in this region 0 to 1. Right, so we need to find this x plus y. Let's say this x plus y is z. Right, so in this case we can say, first of all, let's see the definition or the densities of x and y. It says it is uniformly distributed over the region 0 to 1, whether it is x or y, both are like almost same. In that case, the density is going to be defined as 1 by beta minus alpha. Beta is 1, alpha is 0, so beta minus alpha becomes 1, and the region is between 0 to 1, and it is 0 otherwise, right? f of y is also defined in the same manner. It will be y, that's it, because they are both uniform and defined in the same region. So now we need to see what is f of x plus y. Let's say it is small z equal to. So we have seen that sum of two independent variables will be the convolution of it and will be given as f of x, we can say small z minus y, f of y, and this has already been integrated, so it will be dy from minus infinity to infinity. Right, we have seen the distribution function, and from the differentiation of the distribution function, it is giving you density of f of x plus y, which is given by as the convolution of f of x and f of y. Now we know this, that f of y or even f of x will be defined if the region provided is between 0 to 1, right? So now that we are integrating in terms of y, we'll have to take their limits to be 0 to 1 f of x, and this f of y will become 1, so we can directly write f of z minus y dy, correct? So in that case, now this f of x z minus y will again be defined in the region will be equal to 1, if this z minus y lies between 0 to 1. And from here we can define the region, right? This 0 to 1 range gives you the y to be equal to, we can split it in this manner, 0 z minus y, and we can also split in z minus y should be less than equal to 1. So let's say in both the cases we are trying to see what is the y. So y will be less than equal to z, and in this case it will be z minus y less than equal to y, or otherwise if you want we can leave it till here. Now we know that y will be defined for the region 0 to 1. So if y is defined for the region 0 to 1, what is the minimum z can have? Z has to be greater than equal to 0. So z will be between the region of 0 to 1. Why I am writing 1, we'll see that. We are considering it to be y. And secondly, in this case, you can also write that z is y plus 1. So again, when y is 0, z is going to be 1, and when y is 1, z is going to be less than 2. So I'll say z will be in the region 1 to 2. Right? That is why we are stopping at this point up to 1, because after that, after 1, we are already having this case. So this means this can be splitted into two parts. This convolution can be splitted into two parts, and now we can write it as, for z being between 0 to 1 and for z being between 1 to 0, sorry, 1 to 2. So in this case, in both the cases, f of x, z minus y will be 1. So the limits will be directly 0 to 1 dy, and it will be 1 to 2. Instead of 1 to 2, we can actually write it to be a minus 1. Right? So y has to be less than equal to z. So it is 0 to z, small z. And again, in this case, it will be 1 again dy. The y has the lower limit to be z minus 1. So this will be z minus 1, and the upper limit is going to be 1. Right? Why 1? Because y has a limit of 1. Z has a limit of 2, but y has a limit of 1. Right? So now this integration will directly become z, and this will become 1 minus of z minus 1, which is 2 minus z. Right? So these are the expressions we are expecting. One is this one, and another is this one. The limit range is this, and the another range is this. So in that case, this will be given as, this density function f of x plus y will be given as z if this lies between 0 to 1, equal to is also fine, or 2 minus z if it is from 1 to 2 and it is 0 otherwise.